Thank you, Chairman, sir, for giving me this opportunity. Sir, since time immemorial, skill development as a concept has been prevalent in our country, though in a different forms. Different skills were identified with different caste structures. Skill and caste were interlinked. Each caste was assigned a particular skill. The skills used to be passed on from one generation to another. As the economy development and education spread among the people, the traditional skills are giving way to modern technology, leading to unemployment among the rural artisans. This government has rightly envisaged and launched the skill development program in a big way so as to arrest the trend of rural artisans becoming unemployed and to provide them alternate opportunities so as to become economically independent. For this purpose, I suggest that people from traditional skill-based communities like weavers, carpenters shall be trained and equipped with upgraded skills to enable them to become entrepreneurs. Special focus shall be given to the inclusion of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, minorities, differently abled, etc. in the skill development programs. Sir, focus shall be placed on encouraging women entrepreneurs through appropriate incentives for women-owned businesses. Specialized courses on social entrepreneurship should be introduced in academic institutions. The majority of Indians' vast population is of working age. Urgent and effective actions is needed to capture the demographic potential of India's youth. Despite efforts to hasten the scale-up the process through the creation of National Skill Development Fund, the progress has not been very encouraging. Based on data from the 68th round of NSSO, it is estimated that only 4.69% of India's total workforce has undergone formal skill training, compared to with 52% in the USA, 68% in UK, 75% in Germany, 80% in Japan, and 96% in South Korea. This government has rightly created the Department of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, which later on becoming a full-fledged ministry with NSDA, NSDC, and NSDF under its purview. Sir, Honorable Prime Minister has rightly said, I quote, through a policy-driven approach, we have to wage a war against poverty and we have to win this war. India's youth is not happy simply asking for things. He or she wants to live with pride and dignity. I believe Indian youth has immense talent. They just want opportunities, unquote. The Prime Minister further said that each poor, unprivileged youth was a soldier in this war. Sir, though India has a large number of population in prime age, it currently faces a severe shortage of well-trained, skilled workers. Therefore, we must focus on skill training efforts to meet the demands of employees. In this connection, my request is to accommodate the traditional skill-based communities like handloom weavers by giving them necessary training to upgrade their skills in their own professions and support them with the financial inputs for modernizing their equipment. Similarly, the labor, especially women who have been traditionally employed in BD manufacturing, can be provided necessary skill trainings in alternate areas so they can be relocated to another jobs. So lastly, I'd like to suggest, so skill development, other 10 other ministries have been involved in this, so even environment ministry to be included, so it will really help.